A pink pig. Anyway, I am going to burst your bubble. I am going to break the fourth wall. I'm going to break reality. Because you can thank Microsoft, Intel, corporate America, and China for your Linux. You're welcome. I now angered everyone. So you think that because you're running this unique little operating system that you are saying to big corporations, anti-big businesses, you are pro-independence, you are supporting the little guy. No. This is kernel 6.1, and this has not changed much since then. This is from 2022. It's basically the same. It's just like the neatest way that I found to present it to you guys. If you go in and research today's kernel, maybe some names switch around and some companies switch around. But here's the thing. Linux, the kernel in of itself, Linux, could not exist in the form that it is today without corporate America, China, and multi-million billion-dollar companies are supporting it with development effort and or money, or both of those things. If you think in your tiny little brain that Linux is done by Linus Torvalds and all supported by Clovis users that are not affiliated with any corporations whatsoever, you'd be mistaken. You are living a lie. You can look into some names here, most active developers, and most of these developers are attached to companies or organizations that could not exist without companies. We'll look into one of the testers here in a minute. You can see here, active employees, Huawei, super controversial company, Intel, the unknown, could be anything. We don't know who unknown is. If you say unknown, it's basically people in their basement, you must be wrong. The fair way of putting an unknown is you take those 7.9% and you distribute them equally to all of these here. So all of them get a part of that. That's the most fair way to distribute that. So that basically means it's not changing anything. Unknown means we don't know. So you cannot say that all the unknown are independent developers because we don't know. It could be. It could also all be paid developers for massive corporations. It could be either or. You cannot just say, well, unknown is in our favor because I like it to be. That is being a hypocrite. That's being, well, stupid. Oracle, bad company. AMD. AMD is not a good company. AMD is a fucking bad company. Intel is a bad company. Google is the worst company. Red Hat, Meta, Nvidia, Zoom. Okay company. Oracle again. IBM is not a good company. MediaTek, not good. Broadcom, not good. You know, Lenovo is probably in here somewhere also. Charges and what have, again, we come into the name here. Most active employees from, I think it's 5.16 through the way up to 6.1. Companies. Non-authored sign-offs. Like, the Linux Foundation is a little bit higher than one of the kernel developers. The Linux Foundation is a non-profit that is sponsored by massive multi-billion dollar companies. We will look into that in a second. I don't know why FOSS people, Linux people don't look into this, because it drives me nuts how blindly stupid it is that you don't understand this core simple thing. Let's take this little guy here. I looked him up. He's working for the Linux Foundation. The Linux Foundation could not exist without these partners down here or members. Oh, look, Microsoft is in there. All of these are multi-million / billion dollar companies that makes their money on proprietary intrusive software and not Linux. Their main income comes from proprietary software, not FOSS software. Red Hat, well, Red Hat is part of IBM. SUSE, I don't know if they're in there. Canonical, there's really select few companies where their main business model is FOSS software or open source software. All of the rest of the companies that support Linux or the Free Software Foundation, even maybe GNOME, KDE, you know, all your big open source or FOSS software suites, can only do so because the money or the way that they're getting paid, it is by companies that make their fortune selling or maintaining or doing proprietary shit. I remember a day before all of these amazing, or well, not amazing, but all these rich people started to support Linux. Like, I remember a day where Linux was supported 99% by you and me that donated money, or a random developer out there working on the kernel. Let me tell you how that was. Let's say you got a new graphic card. You may got it to work 50% to the same speed as under Windows in maybe a year. It would take a few months before it actually even worked. A lot of hardware did not work out of the box as it does today. A lot of hardware took months, even years, to get properly supported under Linux. Even with Linux taking over the web server market and the web hosting market. Unless you had something that resembled a server, like you were running C1 processes and server-created hardware, or the same hardware, or close to the same hardware as servers were running, you were shit out of luck. We had to physically go onto a fucking website that was called Linux Hardware or something like that to research if the motherboard you want to buy, it, what worked and what didn't work, what chipset worked and didn't work, and How did you see what chipset worked? Well, you have to see if they were maintaining the same chipset on a server that ran Linux. Because if they did that, there was a high chance that chipset would work on, if it was the same chipset with the same firmware, it would work under Linux on your desktop. It was slow as fuck running Linux back in the day. And this was like this all the way more or less up till 2010-ish. Even when Ubuntu or Canonical came into the market, it took a few years before they actually started to do something. But you have to remember, Red Hat is a multi-million dollar company. They run business. They are a business company. They are in the same boat as Microsoft and Google and what have you not. They just don't make as much money as they do, but they are running a company with the same principles, with the same outlook at the corporate world as Microsoft does, the same with Canonical, the same with SUSE. They are businesses. Red Hat, SUSE, and Canonical has a lot of proprietary bits and bobs. They have shit that only work on their systems. They have software agreements and service agreements that is tied into their software suite. For them, Linux and FOSS is just a platform to serve them their own unique technologies. They only care about FOSS and Linux as long as it makes them money. It's the same with anyone else. What happened when Linux starts to become somewhat popular, when Linux starts to actually become noticeable, and we start to get massive hardware updates, like sometimes hardware even was supported on Linux before than Windows and stuff like that, or they were testing beta version of hardware on Linux. When did that happen? When multi-million dollar companies or billion dollar companies started to invest into Linux. I know you hate to hear this, but you cannot have a lot of the nice things you have today without these companies here. Another bursting bubble. Most people are using FOSS software on other platforms than Linux. There are probably more users of OpenOffice VLC on Windows/macOS than there are on Windows, just for the sheer market share distribution that is right now between those operating systems. The only place where you can say that Linux is having is the most used FOSS software OS is for Linux-only software. How much Linux-only software do we have? Not much. Are there, you know, could you go out there and like, put your finger up to the weather and say, ah, I see that little sparkle over there. That little unique program is, even though it's multi-platform, is mostly used on Linux. Of course you can. What I'm talking about is the majority. The majority of FOSS software is run on non-Linux platforms. The vast majority of support for FOSS software comes from non-FOSS people or non-main FOSS companies, meaning that FOSS is not their main product. They just utilize it, therefore they support it because it makes them able to do and sell their proprietary bits and bobs and pieces. Why do Microsoft embrace Linux? It brings customers in to using their in-house proprietary solutions. People want Linux as a server, web server, and stuff like that. They integrate Linux into Azure. They give developers Linux on Windows so they can sell them Microsoft Office, so they can sell them GitHub subscriptions, so they can sell them Azure subscriptions. Azure is 99% fucking proprietary software, if not more than that. The only reason why these companies are helping you out right now is because right now for them, it makes a business sense. There is a return of the investment. The second that FOSS don't make any financial sense for any of these big companies anymore, like let's say people stop using it, they stop caring about it, their hype, so to speak, is going down, the first thing they're going to do is take out sponsor for the Free Software Foundation, taking sponsorships out from your favorite FOSS software, take sponsorship or development effort out of the Linux kernel, which will slow it down massively, massively. If you honestly think that you are running Linux without being basically Microsoft or not supporting other companies like Microsoft, you're fooling yourself. Because the fact that you're running Linux, you give them a variable reason to do this. You're validating them sponsoring Linux. So you basically what you're saying is, I'm okay with taking your proprietary money while still bitching and moaning about the way you do businesses. And that means that because these companies know how Linux users and FOSS people look at them. And like I said, the only reason they still keep sponsoring FOSS and Linux is because it makes sense for them financially. The second it stopped doing that, you are being cut out. Because why should they support people that don't like them? Why should they support organizations that hate them? Why should they be friendly towards people that want them to not exist in this world? A good example is like the DEI things that's going on with companies that's been going on the last 4 or 5 years. More and more companies are, well, basically gutting out the DEI part of their organization because it's not making them money. People stop caring about it so much because they're batshit crazy most of the time. FOSS is a lot like an idea that's being... It's an unproven idea that has been overhyped. When I mean unproven, we have had FOSS, open source, source code availability, call it what the fuck you will, since the day software got invented. You have to remember, proprietary software is kind of new. You know, closed software is newer than open source because in the beginning, everything was out in the open. Everything was available for the people that had access to it. The only thing that was limiting, you know, you to look at the source code back in the olden days was that you were not in a fucking university or you did not know what talk to the developers that were running down in a server room in a college or an organization, you know. And then some companies start to make money off the said software and they were like, we have to protect our properties, and they did that with proprietary software. Proprietary software is newer than open source or the idea of open source or FOSS. Way newer. FOSS has not changed anything in the development world. It's been speaking about or spoken about a little bit more after Linux came into the world. Granted, more and more people have opened their eyes to it, but it's still not the prominent way of doing things. It's still proprietary, lockdown software. It's working. And when I say it's working, I mean proprietary software can be more secure and more stable than open source software. It all depends on how good the quality of your developers are. The same goes for open source. It can be massively better than proprietary software depending on the quality of the developers, because the community will not catch everything. The community will not be the ones to save your ass. They can help out, they can give you feedback, they may or may not catch some things, but the developers are the one doing 99% of the work, proprietary or open source. The sad reality is, as much as we want to believe this is not true, we cannot live in this world without these people here. We just can't. Someone has to pay for shit. Someone has to pay for shit. Money is the great equalizer. Money is the only thing that makes the world goes around. It is that's how the world is today. So if you are using something for free, if you are using something that you don't pay for, someone somewhere have put money into the pot so that can happen. And 99% of that time, it's people like this. It's either people working for massive companies that are getting paid by massive companies, either directly, indirectly do so, or it's companies themselves that have like departments focusing on doing so. Meaning, again, rarely, really rarely, is anything in this world 100% community sponsored. Rarely. There are a few exceptions out there. There are things out there that are. In software, it's even more rarely than in any other places on Earth, like any other situations. Because most people don't want to work for fucking free. They may start a hobby project. If that hobby project takes too much time, they want, you know, dollar bill y'alls. Like, if you honestly think that if you're running Linux, you are immune for big businesses and corporate America and corporate China and corporate world, you are so far up your own ass. You don't even smell your own farts. You don't even live in the same fucking universe that the rest of the world do. You are out there in fairy tale land somewhere and pretending everything. It's the fucking electrical vehicle thing all over again. You're just removing the problem away from your sight. So with Windows, the problem is that You have Windows right, or Microsoft, right up your fucking tight ass from the beginning. You know that Windows is putting a shit ton of money and taking your data and all of that fucking shit right up your ass. You go to Linux, you're just removing it a step further. So they are companies that now indirectly taking your data the second you go on the internet and blah, 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 blah. But hey, Linux in of itself is not doing much data collection. It's not doing much telemetry, but all the other places are still doing it. You just remove the problem like, oh, I'm not polluting the fucking environment when I'm plugging this electricity fucking jack into my car. Well, 99% or whatever high percent it is of all electricity is made by oils that's coal, that now mean that they need to do more of that, that is now polluting the fucking world even more than if you were running on fucking petrol. Not to mention that a lot of charging stations have fucking diesel generators to help them cope with the demand of electricity. Companies that are going electricity only is putting so much demand of the electricity grid that they can't fucking keep up with it. A company running only electrical trucks in smaller cities, that company alone will take more power than the whole city do in a week. That means more coal, more nuclear power, more whatever, because they're not going over to wind power, they're not going over to solar power, because they're still so inefficient. But for you that's driving the EV car, you don't see the problem, you're not putting gasoline directly or petrol directly into your fucking car, so therefore you must be doing something right. Here, oh, I'm not using a system that right up front is taking my data and massive telemetry, and Microsoft or Apple is plastered all over the place, so therefore I must be doing something right. No, you just removed the problem. You're shielded yourself for seeing what's actually going on. That is that you are still depending on them. You are still depending on Microsoft. You're still depending on Google. And yeah, they will still check your fucking shit. They just don't do it via the OS. They do it via their websites. They do it via YouTube. They do it via almost every activity you do on the internet. So what you really do, just like with EV cars, is that you remove 5% or 1% of the problem that is in front of you and moving that into something that's out of your sight, and therefore think, well, out of sight, out of mind. Run Linux if you just like alternatives. Run Linux if you want to learn an alternative OS. Run Linux if it makes sense for you. But don't fucking fool yourself into believe that these are not the guys that are making sure that you can get all the fucking nice shit you have under Linux. Because without them, I lived a world without them in Linux. You had to do a lot of fucking shit or else nothing would get done, and you don't want to do shit. Again, just like the EV car fucking righteous assholes that think they're, you know, more sane and more righteous than anyone else, they are polluting the world just as much, if not even more. Let's talk about batteries in an electrical car. Making those is polluting the society way more than a petrol car. Like, the whole like environmental thing about EV cars is debunked so many fucking times over and over again, because the way that we get electricity has still not been found out how to do that in more proper way. What they should have been doing first is fixing how to get clean energy. Then we can look into fucking energy cars or electrical cars. Fix clean energy first, then give us electrical car. They did it all fucking backwards. Maybe EVs will then force people to look into clean energy. I don't know. Let's hope that. But it's the same thing here. You just basically run into a fucking EV car this is Linux /Frost software, and think now you're outside of this pollution world of proprietary money and proprietary companies and data collection and telemetry. No, you're not. You're just using a thing that in of itself is not doing much of that to you, but everything surrounding it is doing it even more or the same as if you were using Windows or Mac OS. You have to remember this. Microsoft wants to be Google. You're right. Right now on a Google platform, on your Linux machine. Microsoft is trying everything to do the same fucking intrusive shit that Google does, and you're using their product right now. And it don't matter if you're using it from Windows, Mac, or Linux, it's still doing the same shit. Microsoft is not the worst people here. Microsoft is actually one of the... Microsoft / Apple is actually the least intrusive companies when it comes to your data and telemetry. It's everything else that you have to be worried about. And all those everything else are the ones sponsoring your fucking Linux machines, your FOSS software. So get out of your ass, look at reality. See you all later. Bye bye.